Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope you're doing well. I am feeling a little under the weather, as you can probably tell by my voice. It sounds kind of wrecked, but I did want to get a video in for today. So I did do a 10-minute painting. Before I get into that, I did want to mention my website, coreyfrankcreates.com. You can go there and look at my art shop, sign up for my weekly email newsletter, and that's just at the bottom of each page. You'll enter your first and last name, email address, and then you'll look for the confirmation link in either your inbox or your junk or spam folder. And once you click the confirmation link, you will get a weekly email update from me. So I'd really love it if you go check it out. Again, my website is coreyfrankcreates.com. So I did a jellyfish painting for today, lots of fun loose color. So I'm gonna talk through that at real time speed. So if you wanted to follow along, you certainly could, but otherwise please feel free to just sit back and enjoy. So since this is a quick painting, I'm starting off with no undersketch. I'm just putting paint to paper. You have only 10 minutes, so the whole idea of this series is to get something done in a really short amount of time. It can really boost your confidence and just give you more motivation to keep painting when you can finish something in a relatively short amount of time. So I have this size 1 round brush, and frankly, it's a brand that runs quite large. It's more like a size 6 or 8 even round tip brush, but you can tell it comes to a nice fine point. So that's what I'm using, and that is burnt sienna. So it's a very orangey type brown, and I'm just starting off with the bottom kind of fringe part of the jellyfish's head. And you can tell that I'm working somewhat carefully, just kind of blocking in the color, but not being too focused on exact proportion, as long as by the end there is a recognizable jellyfish type shape. That is the goal of this. So when I need finer lines, I'm going right on the tip of that brush. You can tell right here, the fine lines kind of going up the jellyfish's head. That is a great thing about these round brushes. They come to a fine tip, and you can use them for both detail and shading in slightly larger areas, especially when it's this size. Again, this is a size 1 in this brand, Flydom Art, but compared to most other brands I've seen, it's really more like a 6. And you can tell I'm working wet paint onto dry paper, because if I had water already laid down on the paper, the paint would just flow everywhere and not have nice, sharp, defined edges. So you'll see some of the wet into wet technique later, but right now I'm working wet paint onto dry paper, and I used a little bit of cadmium yellow medium, watered down, to get that kind of yellowish hue between those lines. And honestly, when I do a background, I typically lay that color down first and then put details over their top. So typically, you know, when I have more time, I would have laid out that yellowish color and then put the sort of orangey stripes over the top. But again, kind of working in I'm pretty stuffed up, but anyway, working with a shorter amount of time, I am kind of approaching things in a slightly different way than I would typically do with a much longer, more detailed painting. A little bit of the manganese blue in there for some of that coloring underneath the jellyfish's head. And frankly, a lot of that is probably the ocean water shining through. Now, I didn't have enough time, since it was relatively short, to fill in ocean water around the entire jellyfish, but I did kind of put some blue hues in there later on, so I thought I'm definitely gonna include that kind of not reflective, but kind of through the skin of the jellyfish, that light. And here is where you'll see I have some cadmium yellow light, so it's very pale, cool, lemony type hue, where I'm laying in the paint very lightly with quite a bit of water. And then when I go back over, like right here, the paint just flows, the edges flow into the water. So it makes it more loose and flowy, and the colors sort of bleed into each other. And you can tell that difference between the very sharp delineations on the jellyfish's head versus these tendrils, and they're not really fins, but all the pieces coming off the head of the jellyfish. And that is a little bit of Payne's gray, and then I decided that the ultramarine blue would work better, so that's what I start working with right here. And again, you can just see that's a great example of working wet into wet, where the edges just really soften because the water bleeds out. Taking advantage again of that tip and kind of using a wiggly, squiggly motion to create that shape of the sort of tendril coming off of the jellyfish. And I do that several times, again, back with the cadmium yellow light, just kind of a swivelly motion back and forth is what I'm using. And that red is a quinacridone rose, so it's a really nice rich hue. And I'm just going in very lightly. You can tell I had hardly any paint on there. It was really more water than paint to just give a little bit of a rosy hue. If you want to see the original reference image I'm using for this, it's linked in the description. It's from unsplash.com, so the photos on there are not copyrighted. Or they're copyright free, but I really do like to give the photographer credit because there's some amazing work on there. So again, link in the description if you want to see the original photo, just get an idea of what I was working from. And you'll notice on that original photo how there's some rosy pinkish red hues in there, as well as the blues and the yellows and the kind of oranges. So, and I'm taking a lot of liberties again because this is more free-flowing and not as realistic because there's less time. You can see what really fine lines you can get with this brush, and just working through, there's a hole, so there's the kind of tendrils coming off that have the sort of ruffly edges, and then there's more just the straight kind of lines coming off, thinner lines. So that's what I'm working on here, and switching back and forth between that quinacridone rose and the burnt sienna. You'll notice a lot of it is just kind of a repetitive motion. It's like sweeping motion and just trying to stay on the tip, not press too hard. Because when you do press harder, you get more of those bristles touching the paper and it becomes a wider line. So just trying to be careful and gently lay it in. If the lines are too light, you can always re-wet your brush and then add more paint. Anytime my hand goes out of the frame towards the left side, that means I'm dipping the brush in the water and then coming back to the palette to add more paint. So there you go, right here, I dipped it in the water. And then I did add a little bit. This is cadmium red light, so it's more of kind of an orangey tone rather than that pure red or pink red like the quinacridone rose. So just enjoying the sort of contrasts of color and playing into that quite a bit, and by now it should definitely be hopefully recognizable as a jellyfish creature. Please forgive me for the state of my voice. I'm maybe not speaking as much as I normally would because my voice is a little shot, but we are getting now into that portion where I said I did put some blue around the jellyfish just to make it look like it's in a watery type environment. So I'm using the ultramarine blue, just very lightly went in, and then was careful making sure it did not overlap over the edge of that head. So there's a fine edge or a sharp edge between that line of the head and the water. And then just adding kind of some little kind of circular, almost bubble shapes here and there. I thought that might be kind of fun. And again, not doing the blue over every single part of the painting. I realized very quickly here that I was running out of time. I really needed to add a signature. I had about 30 seconds left. So, excuse me. So I went ahead and added the signature, and then I wanted to add some of my signature, haha, pun intended, splashes of color. So it's right about here. You know, I get a lot of paint and a lot of water and just tap the brush to get some of those dots and speckles and splashes. It really was right about here that I was at the 10-minute mark, but I decided to go ahead and work just a few more seconds. It's maybe about like 30 seconds more to add some quinacridone rose. You can tell that first time I didn't have enough paint in there because it was just water flicking onto the page. And then I wanted to smooth out this one field of blue color because it wasn't kind of as loose and flowy as the other areas of blue. So I went ahead and just softened the edges and extended them to more parts of the painting to finish it off. And there's the final piece. Thank you so much for watching that video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'd really appreciate it. Until my next video, be kind to yourself, be kind to others. God bless, and I'll see you soon.